you have told us that programming has evolved to be very easier these days. So can you tell us how we'll be learning or how to go about programming in this course?
So in this course, we are going to start from scratch. By scratch, I mean absolutely nothing. We only assume that you know how to use your mouse and your keyboard. That's it. Okay? And from there, we are going to go ahead and teach you almost everything of what one is supposed to know in programming. Right? At the end of the course, you'll be ready to call yourself a programmer, and you can actually start programming some non-trivial things.
So you mean to say after 12 weeks of the course, I'll be really knowing all the requirements to write a piece of code?
See, this I should probably take a pause and then make you all realize that programming is a whole lot of practice. It has two steps. One is you need some motivation to program. That the course is going to give you in abundance. No doubts about it. Secondly, you need to do a whole lot of practice. The practice comes with sort of, you should be inspired, so there should be some sort of self-motivation. You should sit with your friends and then talk to them and then see if there is something that you can take up as a challenge and then write a piece of code and then see the output. That is something that we should gradually cultivate, right? With time. This is more like singing. You see, I mean, you cannot become a fantastic, famous singer overnight. It involves a whole lot of practice, a whole lot of thinking, a whole lot of culturing of your voice and things like that. So programming is exactly that. In this connection, I must tell you something, that there are many people who give up on programming, thinking that it is not for them. And I must tell you all something, that to the best of what I have seen, to the best of what is known already, programming is quite straightforward and comes with just a few hours of practice. But a huge deterrent for programming is the demotivation, which generally emanates from your surroundings or your inability to solve something and things like that. So what you must do is go in baby steps. Don't try to do something very complicated in the beginning of your learning of programming. Go in baby steps and go as much as possible. Talk to a whole lot of people. And of course, as and always, keep trying. Right? Nothing like it.
You said about programming and how we go about and all that. Mm-hmm. So how can mathematicians make use of it? Given that I'm a math background, I'm just curious.
So you are from mathematics background. Be it math, chemistry, economics, physics, you name it. Today there's a requirement for all of us to calculate things, to analyze things, right? Something as non-trivial as how much water you intake every day, right? What is the change in weight from the past 3-4 years of an individual, okay? What is the amount of carbohydrates that you take, protein that you take, can have something to say about your health. To analyze this kind of data and to infer something, you need programming. So you see, a nutrition specialist requires programming. See, although you have packages which can be used to get all these things done, you must keep in your mind that these packages have a program inbuilt because of which the package works. And it sometimes helps for you to understand how to program so that you can customize whatever you need to do as per your requirements. So I would say programming is definitely not a must for everyone, but is a great add-on to your skill no matter what you are doing and no matter what background you hail from.